The safety and the efficacy of statin therapy is well established. There are multiple randomized controlled trials that demonstrate that statins can reduce the rate of heart attacks, strokes, and even prolong life in high-risk patients. And so when we evaluate patients and make the decision whether they qualify for statin therapy, we calculate and evaluate their 10-year risk of having a cardiovascular event. And if they get past a certain threshold and they're high enough risk, we recommend a statin because we deem the benefits to outweigh the risks for statin therapy in that patient. So this topic hits close to home because my dad, who's a 65-year-old healthy gentleman and who had a 10-year calculated risk of 11.2%, was started on a statin. And my mom, who I won't say her age because I don't want to get in trouble, but she's a little bit older than my dad, and she had a higher calculated 10-year risk, and she wasn't started on a statin. And so, that really sort of piqued my interest on why is this happening, and is this something that is continuing to happen in the community setting? And if it is, what are some of the underlying reasons for that phenomenon? The PALM registry is a national registry of 138 community practices, primary care, cardiology, and endocrinology practices with more than 7,500 patients who either have known existing cardiovascular disease or are at high risk for cardiovascular disease. What PALM did was they captured details on lipid management for these patients and also captured patient-level beliefs and perceptions about lipid management. And those were captured with patient surveys. In our study, we looked at the categories of patients that weren't on a statin and the reasons why they weren't on a statin. And there were three main categories that we identified. The first was patients who had never been offered a statin. The second was patients that had declined a statin in the past. And the third was patients who had discontinued a statin in the past. And what we identified was that in each of those three groups, female patients were more likely to be either never offered a statin, decline a statin, or discontinue a statin compared to male patients. So in each of those three categories of patients who weren't on statins, we were interested in sort of looking at why that phenomenon was happening. And so for the patients who had previously discontinued a statin, we thought there was a high likelihood that that might be related to statin-related adverse effects, patient-reported adverse effects. And so we identified that many patients in the PALM registry had reported some sort of statin-associated adverse effect, and that the rates of reporting adverse effects between females and males was different. Females were reporting more side effects than male patients. And then when we looked specifically at patients who had discontinued a statin due to a side effect, women were twice as likely to report discontinuing a statin due to a side effect compared with male patients. So the other category was the women that, women versus men who declined statins. And so why are more women declining statins compared to men? And so what we were able to identify was that there were some key differences in terms of patient beliefs and perceptions about statins and also willingness to try statins. So female patients were less likely to believe statins are safe. Female patients were less likely to believe statins are effective. And female patients who had previously been on a statin were less willing to try another statin compared to male patients.